Now let us look at the very first question. In this question they are saying, which of the following assertion is false about the internet protocol, or internet protocol means IP protocol. But you have to make sure that they are asking about false, they are not asking about true, okay? Because most of the time students make mistake while reading this false statement. So the first statement is saying, it is possible for a computer to have multiple IP addresses. Now this statement is actually true, because a computer can have multiple IP addresses, but it is not at all recommended. In most of the books, they have written that a computer cannot have multiple IP addresses. That is not true. Generally, what happens is the IP for one network interface card, one IP address that we use. And if you want to use two different IP addresses, then we can have two different network interface cards on a computer. So in a computer, if you have two different network interface cards, then you can have two IP addresses. But again, it is not at all mandatory that you should have two network interface cards. But rather, even if you have one network interface card, but still you can have multiple IP addresses that can be there. If you're using Windows, this setting is very, very easy. Let me just show you with an example here. Just go to your systems, and in your system, go to your network adapter settings. As you can see, I've opened my network adapter setting. This is a Wi-Fi connection. I can just go to the properties here. In the properties here, let us suppose we are using Internet Protocol version 4, that is IPv4 addresses. Go to the properties of IPv4 addresses, and now here you can use the specific IP addresses that we want. Now you can add your own IP addresses. For example, I can add 192.168.1.1 and so on, and the subnet mask and all these entries here. But if you go to this advanced tab, just click on the advanced, you can see you can even add multiple IP addresses here. I can also add 192.168.1.2, right? So new subnet mask will be added. Again, I can also add one more IP address, maybe 112.112.112.11, and subnet mask will be added, and so on. So this way you can have multiple IP addresses with the same network interface card, but it is not at all recommended to have multiple IP addresses with the same network interface card. So generally students get confused. A computer cannot have multiple IP addresses, but that is not true. A computer can have multiple IP addresses, and it is true. There is no problem with it. So the first statement is true. If you see the second statement, it is saying the IP packet from the same source to the same destination can take different routes in the network. That is also true, because IP uses packet switching. It does not use virtual circuit, or it does not use circuit switching. So because it is using packet switching, that is why a packet from the same source and going to the same destination can take different routes in the same network. So this second is also true. First is also true. In the third case, they are saying the IP ensures that a packet is discarded if it is unable to reach its destination within the given number of hops. That is also true, because for these purposes, we use a field which is called as TTL, which is called as a time to live field. So as soon as the value of the time to live field becomes zero, the packet will be discarded. And the fourth option saying the packet source cannot set the route for an outgoing packet. The route is determined only by the routing table in the routers on the way. So this is false. So first 1, 2 and 3 is true. The fourth one is false. The reason is you can easily specify the route through which a packet should go. And if you remember this IP header, in the IP header there's a field which is called as options. So in the options field, we can easily specify the route through which the packet should go. So it is not necessary that every time only the routers can decide the route. Even the network administrator can also decide the route through which the packet should go. Therefore, the fourth option is false. Option number 1, 2, 3 are true. Correct answer is 4. Look at the next question here. Which of the following functionality must be implemented by the transport layer, transport protocol over and above the network protocol? See, we have already seen what are the responsibilities of transport layer. So this transport layer deals with port to port connectivity, port to port connectivity, or you can say end to end connectivity, end to end. But when we see this network layer, now this network layer only deals with host to host connectivity, host to host connectivity, and data link layer deals with hop to hop connectivity. So the first layer here is the transport layer, and transport layer deals with the port to port, or you can say end to end connectivity. Fine. Now, in this transport layer, we have two major protocols. One is your TCP protocol, and even you have UDP protocol, and after this you also have SCTP protocol. Okay. So TCP protocol is a very secure protocol because it establishes a virtual circuit, and this TCP protocol is very reliable, and it uses the services of IP. But if you see the UDP protocol, UDP is not secure means it is not reliable, because it does not create any kind of virtual circuit. It just uses the services of IP, and in a very limited number of applications we use UDP, wherever we have to send very small amount of data. But otherwise TCP is a very secure because it is reliable and it establishes a virtual circuit. So they are saying which of the following functionality must be implemented by the transport protocol. So they're not asking about the transport layer, they're asking about the transport protocol. Transport protocol means transport control protocol, or you can say TCP. So TCP has to implement the end-to-end connectivity, which is also called as port-to-port connectivity, which is necessary. And here, recovery from the packet loss, that is not mandatory, because it can also be done with the help of your network layer. IP also takes care of the packet loss. Detection of duplicate packet, for this, in case of IP protocol, we use something called as identification field. If you see the IP header, in IP header we use identification field. With the help of this, we can easily detect what are the duplicate packets. And packet delivery in the correct order, this also taken care by your IP protocol, because in IP protocol we have something called as offset field. So to solve this kind of question, you should know the entire structure of your IP header. So in IP header, IP protocol, we use offset field so that we can make all the packets that may arrive out of order in order by using this offset field. And for duplicate packet in IP, we have identification field, and even recovery can also be taken care by the protocols. Okay, so the only important functionality that is must for transport control protocol is to implement the end-to-end connectivity, or you can say port-to-port connectivity. Now let us look at the next question here. Again, this is a GATE 2003 question, which is a 1-mark question. The subnet mask of a particular network is given is this. Which of the following pairs of IP addresses could belong to this network? Now look at this subnet mask. In this subnet mask, we have last few bits we are using as subnet ID. I mean, if you just convert the subnet mask to binary, so it will be 1111111.1111.1111. Here we are using the value which is 31. That means the last 5 bits we have used. So this is last 5 bits and this is the 3 bits. So this is representing your subnet mask. Because if you see this last 5 bits here, these 5 bits, it is showing the value which is 31. So 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3 and 2 to the power 4. If you add all of them, this value will become 31. So that means in the third octet, we have used the last 5 bit as the subnet ID. Okay. Now let us look at these IP addresses. So in these IP addresses, because we have the first 2 octets as totally 1, therefore the first 2 octet should exactly match. So this and this, these are matching, but this value and this value, they are not matching. Obviously, these IP addresses belong to 2 different networks. In the second case, the first 2 octets are exactly matching. That is fine. So in the third option, we have the first 2 octets are not matching, because here this and this octet, they are not matching. So obviously we are not going to check first and 3. In the fourth one, the first 2 octets are exactly matching. So we reduced 2 options by educated guess, because the first 2 octets should exactly match. Now we only have to match the third octet here. If the third octets are matching, then we can say these IP addresses belong to the same network. So here 28 and this should match, and here this one and this one should match. I mean, if we have to take the last 5 bits. So here you can see the number is 28. So how do you represent 28 in binary? So 28 can be represented as 16 plus 8 plus 4. So it can be written something like this: 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. And this 29 can be represented like this: 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. So this is 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 2 raised to the power 4. And this is extra. Okay. So if you do a bitwise AND with this one, okay, so why do you use this subnet mask? Subnet mask is used if we do a bitwise AND of this subnet mask with the IP address, then we'll get the network ID. So if you take this one, and if you take this entire subnet mask, the first IP addresses, let me just clear it up first again, so that it will come clear. So we don't have to check option number 1 and 3, so we are only checking option number 2 and option number 4. So let me just give you a brief idea about subnet mask first. So we use subnet mask to identify the network ID. For example, here the subnet mask is this. So how do we find the network ID? We use a bitwise AND here. So for example, here the first IP address is 10.35.28.2, and here the subnet mask is 255.255.31.0. Then we have to do a bitwise AND. Bitwise AND, that means convert these numbers to bits so that you can get a bitwise AND. So because here the first two octets are 255, so the first two will be exactly the same. The only the third one will change. And here we know how this 28 is represented. So 28 is represented something like this: 0 0 0 1 1 1 0 0. Okay, and how this 31 is represented in binary? So it is 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 1. So if you do a bitwise AND of these two, you will get 28 dot, and because this is 0, so it should also be converted to 0 after bitwise AND. In the same way, you have to do a bitwise AND of this IP address. So second IP address is 10.35.29.4, and here we have subnet mask as 255.255.31.0, and if you do a bitwise AND here, so it will give us 10.35.29.4.0. Now here, because this third octet is not matching, so you can see this value and this values are not matching. Therefore, we can say these two IP addresses belong to two different networks. Hence, this cannot be an answer. Check out the option number 4. So in the option number 4, we have 128.8.129.43. And subnet mask is 255.255.31.0. Okay, and do a bitwise AND. Now try to convert this 129 to binary. This will become 1000001, and this 31 is 0001111. If you do a bitwise AND, only the last bit will match. So this will become 128.8.1.0. This is the network ID here. And in the next IP address here, in this case, so it is 128.8.161.5. And the second here is 255.255.31.0. We have to do a bitwise AND here. So in this case, we have the number which is 161. So how do you represent 161? So 161 is 128 plus 32 plus 1. So this can be presented as 1010001, and this 31 is represented as 0001111. Now if you do a bitwise AND of all these, bitwise AND is 128 dot bitwise AND again 8 dot, here we will get only the first last bit will be matching. We will get 1.0. Now you can see this network ID, this is the network ID, this is exactly matching with this network ID. Therefore, we can say the correct answer is option number 4. Both these IP addresses belong to the same network. Here 2 is not a correct answer because their network IDs are not matching. Okay, so this was gate 2003 question. Now let us take gate 2004 questions on network layer.